Hi, my name is Kylie, and welcome to the world. Our world is a fascinating place. In this video, you'll learn the seven continents and the major oceans in the world. You'll also learn facts about how the world is divided and how to tell the direction from anywhere on the planet. Let's go explore this wonderful world. The world is our beautiful planet, Earth. When we talk about the world, we are talking about the people, plants, and animals that all live here. We're also talking about the land and the bodies of water. Because it is so big, the world has been divided or separated into seven geographic regions called continents, which makes it easier to talk about the countries within them. Continents are large areas of land that include many countries within them. The seven continents are North America, South America, Africa, Europe, Asia, which is the largest continent, Oceania, and Antarctica. To learn more about each of these continents, be sure to watch our world trip videos. Almost three-fourths of the Earth's surface is covered by oceans and seas. An ocean is a large body of salt water, and a sea is smaller than the ocean. Most of the oceans and seas are connected to each other. There are five oceans in the world: the Arctic Ocean, which is the smallest ocean, the Atlantic Ocean, the Indian Ocean, the Pacific Ocean, which is the largest, and the Southern Ocean. To talk about the location of continents, countries, and oceans in our world, we can use the four points of a compass: north, south, east, and west. A compass is a tool that tells the direction of things, like where your home is found in our world. Our world is further divided into four main sections called hemispheres. The equator is an imaginary horizontal line around the center of the Earth. It divides the Earth into the northern and the southern hemispheres. All continents, countries, and oceans found above the equator are considered to be in the northern hemisphere. And continents, countries, and oceans located below the equator are considered to be in the southern hemisphere. North America is located in the northern hemisphere. The vertical imaginary line through the center of the Earth is called the prime meridian, and it divides the world into the eastern and western hemispheres. You can guess where the continents and countries to the west of the prime meridian are located? Yes! In the Western Hemisphere. So that means that continents and countries located to the east of the prime meridian are in the Eastern Hemisphere. Super! The USA and Canada are located in the Western Hemisphere. Actually, we say they're in the Northwest Hemisphere because they're in both hemispheres. Cool, huh? Hemisphere lines might be invisible on Earth, but they are actually drawn on maps. Now, the equator and the prime meridian aren't just randomly placed around the Earth. Scientists who study the Earth, our geographers, agreed many, many, many years ago on a system of more imaginary lines that run up and down or north to south along the prime meridian. And they agreed upon a system of lines that ran east and west across the Earth in the same direction as the equator. These lines are called lines of latitude and longitude, and they are measured in degrees. The prime meridian is considered to be at 0 degrees longitude. Around the opposite side of the prime meridian, the longitude is 180 degrees longitude. Then all of that space is filled in with more lines of longitude called meridians. Each line equals 1 degree. With each of the degrees going around the world from 0 to 360. Can you guess why? That's right, it's because the distance around the Earth's measure is exactly 360 degrees, a full circle. Hey, you just noticed what scientists discovered years ago. The Earth is round, cool. The same is true for lines of latitude. The Earth equator horizontally runs from east to west around the Earth. It measures 0 degrees latitude. Each of the imaginary lines going around the Earth in the same direction as the equator is called a parallel because they're parallel to the equator. These lines of longitude and latitude create a neat grid around the world. Where the lines meet is a point called a coordinate. Now, a coordinate tells you the exact spot in the world where you are located right now. You can learn more about our world in a special book called an atlas, where you can find many beautifully illustrated maps. You can also find online atlases and apps for kids so that you can learn on the go. Speaking of learning on the go, be sure to watch our videos that teach about our world and then practice what you learned on our fun online games and quizzes. Remember, keep traveling and always be clever. Hey, hey.